have to eat the dream. You have to sleep the dream. You have to dream the
What's
dream.
What's going on, Strength Team family? Look, I'm right back with another great video. If you're new to the Strength Team family, welcome to the Strength Team family. All we do over here is get gains. If you have any video suggestions or any video requests, all you gotta do is put them at the bottom and I promise you I'm gonna make that video happen. Listen, like I promise you, here is the best meal prep video that is probably on YouTube. If you have not seen my first one, this one right here is a 12-week shredding diet. It will show you exactly what you need to do. Workouts, I mean your supplements, your cardio, everything that you possibly could think of, everything is included. In 12 weeks, I guarantee you will get shredded, and I mean just probably in the best shape of your life, or at least the best shape you have been in a very long time. And after you finish those 12 weeks, once you get rid of all that excess of fat, now you can come to this video. I'm gonna show you how to build lean muscle. This video right here is gonna help you to build muscle without putting on all that just excess fat, all the excess weight. You're not gonna do that. The macros are perfect. Like, so if you weigh like around 180 to 220 pounds, this right here is gonna be perfect for you. If you weigh a little bit more, all you got to do is just make a little bit of adjustments and it's still going to be perfect for you. And the exact same thing if you don't weigh as much. All you have to do is just tweak it to make sure the macros are perfect for you. Now listen, I'm going to show you meal by meal. I'm going to show you how to cook every single food that's involved, and also to make this even better, I'm going to add in 8 free weeks of workouts. I mean every single day, 5 days a week, I'm going to give you the best workouts that you have ever in your life tried. Now I know y'all thinking, my gosh, this man is giving us all this for free. You know why? Because I want us all to get these gains. Now let's go straight into the house. Okay, now here's your grocery list. You're gonna need some whole eggs. You're gonna need some liquid egg whites, some instant oatmeal packets, some raw oats, natural Skippy peanut butter, some red delicious apples, some bananas, some chicken breasts. I normally get like 6 pounds, usually lasts for the whole 7 days. And then you're gonna need 93% lean beef. If you don't want beef, you can do turkey instead. Either way, I normally get 3 to 4 pounds. Then you're gonna need basmati or jasmine rice. I normally go back and forth between the two, that way I don't get too tired of one of the flavors. Then you're gonna need sweet potatoes. I normally get 5 to 6 pounds. Then you're gonna need fresh or frozen green beans or broccoli or your favorite greens. You can use spinach or whatever your favorite greens are. Then you're gonna need some protein powder. My choice is Optimal Nutrition. Then you're gonna need some coconut oil. If you don't wanna use coconut oil, you can use olive oil or you can use avocados instead. Then you're gonna need some Greek yogurt. And here's some extra items that I got. I got some Body Armor super drinks. I got pineapple coconut, and I love to drink these while I'm working out. Also, if you do not have no food storage containers, go to Walmart because they hands down are the cheapest, or get them on Amazon. You don't have to have this, but if you're new to cooking, get you a digital cooking thermometer. It's gonna make everything that much more accurate and that much more easier. That way you don't have to guess if your chicken is done or if your beef is done. That way you don't overcook it, because listen, you do not wanna overcook your chicken because it's gonna be dry, and every day that it sits in the refrigerator, it's just gonna make it that much more miserable when you try to eat it. Go ahead and invest in some digital kitchen scales. You can find these for like $15. Okay, this is what you're gonna eat for meal number one. You're gonna have one whole egg and you're gonna cook it. You're gonna have 150 grams of liquid egg whites, that is uncooked weight. Then you're gonna have 2 packets of the instant oatmeal. My flavor is cinnamon and apple, but like I mentioned earlier, you can use any flavor that you like. And then you're gonna have 1 tablespoon of your peanut butter, which is gonna weigh out to 16 grams. And then you're gonna have 1 red delicious apple. Now I'm gonna show you how to cook it. You're gonna crack the egg and put everything inside a cup. Now you're gonna weigh out 150 grams of your liquid egg whites. You're gonna stir them together for a few seconds. Now, preheat your oven eye to medium high. Once it's hot, add 1/2 tablespoon of butter, or you can use cooking spray. Now, pour your eggs and your egg whites into the pan. Stir for a few minutes until your eggs are done. Pour 2 packets of oatmeal in a bowl. You're gonna add 1.5 cups of water, and you're gonna cook it on high in the microwave for 1 to 2 minutes. Now, after that's done, weigh out 16 grams of peanut butter and add it to the oatmeal. I'm telling you, that mixture is just delicious. Mix it all up, rinse your apple off, and dry it and eat it, and that is meal number one. Now, meal number two, we have 5 ounces of cooked, grilled, or baked chicken breasts, 250 grams of basmati or jasmine rice, and that's cooked weight. And then we're gonna have 4 ounces of fresh or frozen green beans. This is also after it is cooked. So now I'm gonna show you how to cook meal number two. Go ahead and take 5 to 6 pounds of chicken breasts. Now cut excess fat off and just trim it up however you like it. Now you're going to take your favorite seasonings, go ahead and season the chicken. I only use chicken by Mrs. Dash and black pepper, but you are more than welcome to use any season that you like. Now go ahead and preheat your grill to 450 degrees. Now once the grill is hot, put the chicken on the grill and cook it for 4 to 6 minutes. Now flip the chicken over and cook it for another 4 to 6 minutes or until the internal temperature reaches 165 degrees. Now go ahead and measure out your rice. Now just remember, for 1 cup of rice, you have to add 1.5 cups of water. I take the rice and I go ahead and I rinse it off really well. Then I go ahead and drain it. Now I'm going to add the rice and the water to the pan. I'm going to turn the oven on high and bring the water and the rice to a boil. Now once it starts boiling, go ahead and turn the temperature down to low heat and cover it and cook it for 20 minutes. Now every single rice is going to be different. It may tell you to cook it for 12 to 15 minutes. So make sure to look on your bag to see the exact cooking times. Now go ahead and turn off your oven iron, remove the pot from the heat, and let it sit for 8 to 15 minutes. Again, you'll have to look at your bag because it may be different. It may tell you to let it sit for 12 minutes. So make sure you are looking at the directions because every single rice is going to be different. Now go ahead and add your frozen veggies to a steamer and then just turn on your oven eye to medium high and just let it go until it starts steaming. Now if you want to use the microwave, hey, it's perfectly fine. All you're going to do is put the whole entire bag in there and just follow the directions on the bag. Some of us want to say cook it for 5 minutes, some's going to say cook it for 10. It depends on the wattage of your microwave. So again, make sure you're looking on the bag for the cooking directions. And that's meal number two. Okay, now here's meal number three. You have 5 ounces of 93% lean ground beef. Or like I say, you can also use ground turkey, and this is your cooked weight. And also you have 250 grams of sweet potatoes. Again, that is your cooked weight. And then you have 4 ounces of fresh green beans or broccoli. And again, that is your cooked weight. And this is how you cook meal number three. You're going to take 3 pounds of your 93% lean ground beef, and you're going to season it to your liking. I use Gourmet Burger by Weber and just a little bit of black pepper. Now, once you season it, now you got to massage your meat. Make sure you massage all your meat until your seasoning is all over your meat and just season really well. Now go ahead and roll your meat into 6 ounce balls and then pat them out. Just pat them out where they're kind of flat just a little bit. That way they're going to cook evenly. Now you're going to clean your grill and go ahead and set your temperature to 400 degrees. Now go ahead and start putting your burgers on the grill and you're going to cook them for 5 to 6 minutes. After 5 to 6 minutes is up, go ahead and flip over your burgers and you're going to cook them for another 5 to 6 minutes or until your internal temperature reaches between 150 to 165 degrees. It just depends because some people want their meat well done, and then some people likes it medium well, or however your liking is. So that's why I say it's 150 degrees to 165 degrees. So that way it's going to be your preference. Okay, now you're going to take 6 pounds of raw sweet potatoes and you're going to take a fork and you're just going to poke several holes all the way around the potatoes. Now you're going to put them in the microwave and you're going to cook them for 6 to 12 minutes or until they're tender. Now all microwaves are going to be different just because of the wattage. You may have a 800 wattage microwave or you may have like a 12 to 1600. So they're going to cook different temperatures. So just check them maybe halfway through. You can flip over the potatoes as well and just see when they're tender. Go ahead and let them rest for at least 5 minutes because they are going to be hot. Now once they have cooled off, go ahead and take your knife and just cut the potatoes right down the middle and just use a spoon and just scoop out all the insides of the potatoes. And then just take your 4 ounces of your green beans or your broccoli. There's meal number three. Now just remember, meal number three is going to be your pre-workout meal. That's going to be the meal you eat right before you go to the gym. No matter if you work out at 5 o'clock in the morning or no matter if you work out at 6 o'clock in the afternoon, meal number three is always going to be your pre-workout meal. Now, meal number four, that's your post-workout shake. Now listen, you do not have to drink a shake immediately after your workout. The only reason I do that is because I normally work out at 6, so by the time I get done working out, it's like 7:15. So I'll go ahead and try to drink this because I still have another meal, and I'm trying to get to sleep around like 11. So that's the main reason why I drink my protein shake immediately after my workout. Now, meal number four, you're going to have 16 ounces of water, or you can use almond milk, or you can use whole milk. I'm going to leave that up to you. Then you're going to take 1 scoop of Optimal Nutrition or your favorite protein powder. Then you're going to take 1 banana. You're going to take 1 tablespoon of your peanut butter, which is going to weigh out to 16 grams. Then you're going to take 1/2 cup of raw oats. Now what I do is I take those raw oats and I put them in a blender by themselves and I just blend them up. That way they become real fine and almost powdery. That way it doesn't make your shake like extremely chunky. You don't have to do that, but I do that, and me personally, I like it better. Now all you're going to do is maybe add you a couple pieces of ice. Go ahead and mix all that up together, and this shake actually tastes really, really good. Meal number five is the last meal of the day. We have 5 ounces of grilled chicken. Of course, that is your cooked weight. We have 275 grams of basmati, or you can use jasmine rice. Again, that is cooked weight. We're gonna take 7 grams of our coconut oil and we're gonna pour that over on top of our rice. Then you have 4 ounces of your fresh greens. It could be green beans, it could be broccoli, it could be spinach, whatever your favorite green vegetable is, that is perfectly fine. Then you're gonna take your Greek yogurt and eat it, and that is it. That is meal 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now meal number one, I cook that fresh every single morning. It literally only takes me like 15 minutes. It don't take no time to go ahead and scramble up your eggs and your egg whites, and then just throw your oatmeal in the microwave, and then you have your apple. So meal number one, I never prep that. If you wanna prep that, that's perfectly fine, but I just don't know how it's gonna be when you're gonna try to warm up your eggs. I'm sure it's gonna have your house smelling kind of crazy, but if you want to, if you think that saves a little bit of time, hey, that's perfectly fine. But me personally, I cook meal number one fresh every day, just like my post-workout shake. I make that after my workout every single day. It only takes like 5 minutes. But again, if you wanna go ahead and prep that maybe the day ahead, hey, that's perfectly fine. But meal number two, like what I do is I go ahead and I just prep them all out for Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. I literally take it out and I weigh out all of my chicken, I weigh out all of my rice, I weigh out all of my greens. I put them in a container and I just put them in the refrigerator. Now, they'll tell you that maybe 3 days is all you can really leave it in there. I've been doing this for years and I have left it in there for 5 days. Now, I'm not gonna say leave it for 6 to 7 because you're starting to push it. So if you're more comfortable, you honestly can prep Sunday and Wednesday. That way you're only leaving your food in the refrigerator for 2 to 3 days instead of 4 to 5 days. I'm gonna leave that up to you, but I'm just telling you, I have done it for years and I've never got sick or anything, because you gotta think, once you put it in the microwave, you're pretty much cooking off any type of bacteria that may have built up or anything like that. Most people fail because it's not convenient for them. So that's why you meal prep. Once you meal prep, it's convenient. Just like you can go through a fast food restaurant, like through a drive-thru, it's convenient for you. So already having your food in a refrigerator, already weighed out, is so convenient. All you do is put it in the microwave, warm it up, get it out, eat, and get your gains. Now, this is everything you need. Also, like I told you, I'm gonna put all kinds of workouts down below. So all you gotta do is click on the links. It's gonna be 4 weeks at a time, just like this video. Every 4 weeks, I'm coming back with you and I'm gonna show you the updates. All it will be is I probably may change out the chicken for this, or maybe change out the beef for that, or add a little bit of more for my carbs or anything. But anything that I do from here on, I'm gonna show y'all. I want to show y'all everything, that way y'all can get all the gains that I'm getting. But like I say, I'll see y'all in about 4 weeks for another video like this. But I'll see y'all tomorrow for another great workout. Every single day I'm bringing you workouts. It is time to really get these gains. But like I say in every single video, make sure you like this video. Make sure you share this video. But at the end of the day, make sure you keep getting them gains.
You have to eat the dream. You have to sleep the dream. You have to dream the dream.